Well, here we are in the desolate highlands of Chance for Paradise. I'm not sure why you need dangerous cliffs for a paradise, but, to each their own, I guess. So last time we got pretty thoroughly confused by a couple of rooms here. And, we only got, three rooms solved already, and we seem to be pretty far into this wing, so I feel like probably the best way of doing this would probably be to just go to another room and find out more about these sun things, because I only discovered late into the last episode that you could actually step into these things to move them, like mirrors. Even though you can push them with your sword, you can also step into them. So there might be more properties of these that I don't quite get yet, so there might be more tactics yet to discover, is what I'm getting at. So maybe this other wing will teach us more about that, and that'll help us with some of these advanced rooms on the other side. Alright, so for instance, what's going on here? Sir, you have anything say for yourself? No, you're just somebody who lets us out. Alright. So you're somebody who will let us out as soon as we kill all these. And all we need to do is just activate them so we kill all of them. So, why don't we just do the natural thing and kill them in order? If we're not going to be allowed to move. If we aren't going to be allowed to move, then why don't we just do something like this? Right, you can't kill them on the turn that they step into something, so I want to, I'm going to have to kill this in a little bit of a different way. That's not going to be far enough away. Like, I'll show you what happens, because we'll kill this, right, how'd that get there? Also, right, this has to be three away. And then that has to be four away. So yeah, what's going on here? Because I can't just set up a spiral. I don't have enough room for that. Like, it looks nice and all, but there's not enough room for it. And I can't step anywhere else once that's done. So maybe I have to kill them. Maybe I have to kill them one by one then. Like, let's start with this. I guess we're going to have to use movement order. Okay, let's have fun with that. This guy moves first. Okay, so this is the first moving one. Then I guess we want, this. And I guess we're gonna have to hope we kill all of them. That's gonna be good times. Yeah, so we probably want number three, then number four on, like, this side. Because we're gonna want them all to come in. We want them all to get blocked by each other, essentially. But not to sidestep each other. So then we probably want, like, yeah, actually that would be pretty good, is, number four here, and then number five, like, here. Sure, that sounds good. And then, like, only have a really late moving thing, here. So number seven should go, like, yeah, number six should go here, then number seven should be the last thing. No, you want number... Yeah, we want number seven to... We want number five to go in here after these guys move. Or, no. If this moves over here sideways, then this one's gonna be bad. So actually, we want, like, number three to... Yeah, number three will go down here. We're gonna have to do this in order, because that's the only way that this is gonna work if we have this little space to work with. Yeah, so let's see where we're at now. So we're gonna go up here. Number two's gonna go over here. We want three to go over here. Then we just kind of want them all to filter in. So three will go here, then something will go here, and stuff's not gonna get blocked. So that actually looks pretty close to the right solution. Let's see how this works. There we go. So let's back up and see why this worked. So number two goes here, then number three follows in behind us like that. Then this one just slides along. This one filters in, and then these ones move last, and they just kind of follow wind and movement. So the net effect is that kind of everything kind of streams in either on the north side or the west side, and nothing ever wants to move here, because every time we get here to this point where Beethro faces north, this one is always moving before this one. So this one always gets first choice to move southwest into the western tile where it wants to. And nothing ever wants to move southeast to this tile where we have, like, you know, this problem where they go on either side of themselves. Okay. So I don't know whether that counts as a magic sequence room, but at least I figured it out fairly quickly. Because it's just movement. I mean, you know, you can predict these things as long as you know what order they move in. And you can right-click on them to see what order they move in, and they are predictable in their movements, so... I don't know, I got a little bit lucky with how the end worked out, but I set something up that worked according to principles that I liked, and it worked. There's probably multiple solutions to this, but that would be, you know, that's the first one I came across, so that's nothing more to say about that one. Okay, but that doesn't really tell us what we're missing for these other two, so I don't know, let's try another room. Yeah, we'll be back for this later. This seems to be the simpler one compared to this thing. We'll be back for that, too. But... okay, a secret. Alright, I mean, I guess we were a little bit short on voice actors, but we really could have found somebody to say something for this one. I mean, come on. You always have to have a smug guy voice for this. Alright, so what's going on here? Something's going on here. Alright, so we have to kill the roach. How do we kill the roach? What lets it out? This lets it out. So, Beethro is the only thing that can press that. So Beethro goes over here. So the roach comes out. We need to block it from going in there. Sure. Then we need to block it from going in here. Sure. And then we need to block it from going in there. And then it comes out. Sure. So three things go in there. Alright, I get that part. Then we come... yeah, we go here, this goes here. That kills the roach. And... yeah, I don't get it. What's the rub? Like, we just have to put the three things in there. Then we let them out. And then... yeah, that opens that and opens this. Okay, so the thing is, we can't push them in here directly. No. We have to do it in such a way that we just fiddle around with them in this chamber. Then we use these things to make them all go where they're supposed to. So they go in here, and then in here, and then in here. So we need these things, and we need to mess around with the movement order then, probably, to get them to behave in the way that okay, but well, we can still do that, though. Well, I think I'm getting close. Alright, so before we go in here, we go in here. That closes this, then that opens this, and then we can't get back in. That's all normal. That's all well and good. So, they will move like roaches. And additionally, we can use movement order to kind of split them up. And that is a south-facing forcer, so that's only for the roach to go. We need... sending something up here is easy. Sending something over here, less so. These are the only two tiles we get. Yeah, the only two, and they're essentially the same. You really could have only given us just one, I think. Yeah, just one. One would have been enough. So what's the significance of having two separate activation tiles, then? None that I can figure out. They're just the same, because they're both northeast of all this. Now, these things do move like Olmgoog, so they can sidestep if they have to. I wonder if that extends to their preference. Do they have horizontal preference sometimes? Okay, well, let's find out. I don't think we've ever had enough of a separation to really find out, so let's find out. Yes, sometimes they move horizontally. Because this diagonal is lined up directly through here. So this is how you get some of them to go horizontally. fact, yeah, you can get something to go horizontally here, too, in fact. So, yeah, let's do that. So, we shouldn't need much to do this. Because we just need the first one to go horizontally. Then it's just taken care of. Right. So then they need a certain distance compared to each other. So this is 4-way. Then the next one, this is 4-way, and the next one, this is 4-way. So they do have to be in movement order as well. So let's put number 2 up here first, then number 3, then number 4. And we might as well keep this guide up because we're going to need it. So then they all follow in, so that goes up there, then both of these go up there, then that goes up there, then this goes up here. And that's too far away. Right, yeah, because they obviously didn't all start in the same place. So they're going to be staggered, so that means I actually want the north one to go up first, I think, then probably north again, then east. Alright, that's close. Yeah, so it doesn't matter whether this one is here or here. It just matters whether this one has to be either here or here, and this one has to be here or here. So this one actually can be delayed a bit. In fact, this is probably the best place for it. So actually, that means we probably want this to go up first. So up first, then over. And then that would actually be fine as long as this one then moved, was already here, right? So then we, like, make that go over, and then that has time. Yes, that's sort of the right idea. Yeah, but it has to slide down here initially. Okay. But I think we're sort of getting the right idea. But it seems like it's best to just make them go in and move in order, because I don't see, like, how delaying So that happens. And it's okay if that one arrives late. So that's sort of the right idea. Well, I could use movement order to... No, I couldn't. Because this funnel means that, any gaps that would occur, like if this one moved up, like if this one moved first and this one moved second, then we'd just get a gap here when they got funneled through here, and that wouldn't help. So, effectively, this is just the best way of handling it anyways, just putting them in ascending movement order, first front, and then last, and then just messing with the gaps in the meantime. So how would gaps help us? So, the only valid distance from the entrance is 5 here. 5 moves from here to here. For this, the valid distances are either 4 or 5. So you can have 5 here, 4 or 5 here, and then 4 or 5 here. Yeah, either of those would work, 4 or 5 here. So it's just a matter of getting all of them to be the correct distance away. So, actually, that seems to imply that we want, like, 3, 4, 5 at some point, right? Yeah, 3, 4, 5. Because then we could put 1 to the 5 first, then the 4 second, and the 3 last. So where would a 3 be appropriate? So 3 doesn't help here. 3 goes here, and then... Yeah, so 3 away is, like... Here. No, not here. Here. And elsewhere. So there's nowhere a 3 would be appropriate. So it's just 4, 4, and 5. So that seems to mean that we should have a gap then. Okay. Fair enough. I can accept that. I don't think we need this filter anymore. I think I kind of get the picture. Alright, so what would this mean then? That would mean that the front one would go ahead of the others. Or maybe we don't. Maybe we want this. Okay, let's see if I can get anything done with this then. So this means that the fourth one is just delayed by 1 compared to the others. So that means that the front ones have to go the furthest, which means that they have to go up. Okay, so like that, except that I probably actually want these to go first, then how's that look? I mean, that's sort of the right idea, but if, like, this one could have already been here, like, four away. So let's review. This moved 5 squares, this moved 4 squares, this moved 3 squares. No, in fact, it actually only moved 2. Yeah, that moved 2 squares. So that's the only effect that delaying that had, is it moved from 3 squares away to 2 squares away. So we could have had, like, this situation instead. So what we want is 4, 4, and 5. Right? Because there's no other way to move them. These are the only places that you can move them. This only gets unlocked later. So, right. So this is actually very constraining, is this 5 here. I mean, we could put it in much later, but that, like, if this goes in any later, like, if this is considered to be 6 moves away after we start moving this, then that just moves everything else up. And that doesn't seem to be what we want, because this ideal location here is either 4 or 5 away, and this ideal location is either 4 or 5 away. So that seems to imply that this, like, one of these is 5 and one of these is 4. So what does that mean? So can we do 6, 5, 4? Well, that's the same as 5, 4, 3. No, it's not quite the same. Well, it's 5 away from this point, whatever that means. So, you know, something's going to go here. Then we could have a gap. Like, we could. But then that's just the same as starting it further away anyway, so that's just equivalent. Yeah, so this is fine, and that's fine, because we made that split. So those are... Yeah, so that followed immediately afterwards. So yeah, this is a way to get 5 here and 4 here. And this is only 2 because it started for me. So the 3 is not helping. Now we could have this be 5 and this be 4. That would be fine. It's just that we would want that to also be 5. And we need at least 5 to get up here in the first place. And once it gets in here, then, well, that's just game over, because this is long. Yeah, so it has to be here, precisely. That's the only place that this works. If it goes in here, then that's bad. So, at some point, five turns have to pass from here to here. So that's the constraint. So that seems to imply that 4 goes here. And then 3 can't go any further. So there's something funny going on here with movement. Do you have anything else to say? Nope. Alright, I guess not. I mean, I guess if he had anything else to say, it would be a hint. We don't want hints, do we? Now there's no other way to remote manipulate these things, right? Like, it's not like, I can push them outside the entrance. I mean, okay, so we can do that. That doesn't seem to help matters. I mean, sure. But... So what would that imply? We can put as many... We can't put as many of these as we want. We can only put, Yeah, we could only get one out. So what would that imply? We can put some in. And we wouldn't be able to do anything in particular with this, no. Because we can't feed it back into this mechanism anyhow. Like, nothing's happening here. And there's no way to, like, reopen that in any way. Yeah, so I'm not seeing a way to make any additional obstacles. We can't press this early or anything like that. right? Because that's just never gonna... Yeah, it flies. It doesn't press pressure plates. Okay, so that seems... That does not actually seem to do anything. It was a nice try, but I don't think that does anything. Well, I am trying, sir. I'm trying very hard here. Alright, so what else can I try, then? This is the only way out. I mean, I can press this first if I want to, and then press that. I mean, okay, that didn't do anything. Or did it? Like, I can. Like, what would that imply? That implies that I do something up here to mess with them in the state that they're in now, which, is gonna mean that they come in just 2-3-4 order with no gaps anyway. I can do whatever needs doing. Then I can press that and then press that. And then I can just wander here and do absolutely nothing. Alright, well that was productive. I mean it was worth a try though. Gotta try these things, just to make sure that, you know, there's no hidden benefit to this, because that's often what's going on in puzzles like these, is there's something sneaky that you can do that it gives you an advantage. Because, like, you feel like you can't do it with the stuff that you have, but you can get an extra resource that helps you. But I don't think getting this out of here is the right answer. Because then that just leaves two in there, and then you're just not any better off at all. So if we don't mess with them at all, like, if we just go straight for this, then they're just going to come in this order, 2-3-4, which is normal. So the only thing that you do in here is separate them such that there's a gap in this order, 2-3-4. You can make them come in different orders, but what that will do is it'll just create a gap. Like, if I put 4 first, then you just have 4 in front and then 2 in back, and I don't think you could really do anything with it. So what else can I do? I can't delay these indefinitely. They're always going to follow a path out to its logical conclusion. I can't get them to switch tracks or otherwise delay themselves once they're in there. They're always going to march forward at a rate of one tile along the path. I mean, they can choose to go either north or east at these intersection points depending upon where Beethro is standing on here, where Beethro is standing relative to this diagonal, when they get there. But they can't, like, delay themselves with respect to a certain path. They're always going to go along whatever path towards their final journey, destination, they get to. What movement order do we have here? 2-4? Sure. So, I mean, I don't see any particular reason to keep messing around with stuff like this, but I guess it's worth a try. Alright. So here, the frontmost is going to take 5 to get someplace, and then the rest are going to just, you know, now it's just like a matter of, instead of like 5-4-3, it's going to be 5-3-2, and that's not even any better now. Like, how's this improve? That's, this is 5, this is 3, and that's 2. And there's nowhere that I can make something be longer than 5. Like, this is a 5. This square right here, 18-16, that's 5 away from this point, the door. So that's a 5. And this is a 5. But this is also a 5. Like, this is 5 squares away. And if it's 6, then it's just not any good. Because then the roach gets trapped here and there's no way it goes down here. I could put 2 sun things in there, such that this is a 6 and this is a 5, but that doesn't seem any better. Yeah, I want one obstacle for each of these 3 rows, which is precisely because of, you know, this thing. Then this never opens again. Okay. And also, interestingly enough, it closes this again. Which is very interesting. Why would that be necessary? The only reason I would see that being necessary is if Beethro somehow pressed this plate early. Yeah, some things don't press plates, only Beethro, only Beethro roaches do. I don't think there's any way to get Beethro, right? Yeah, there's no way to get Beethro in there, because anytime he's in here... this is closed. And the only way to open it again would be to seal himself out of it. So that's an airlock. Only these things, the sun things, can go through there. Yes. Maybe I should leave and re-enter. Is that going to reset his speech? Nope, it's not going to reset his speech at all. Nope, not in the slightest. I'd like to get this, this would be pretty neat. It would save me some time later. So let's see here. So what else haven't I tried yet? I'm trying a lot of things that are similar, which is the problem. Like, a lot of things just boil down to being the same thing, which sort of helps. It helps you focus on what's really important, but it also means that if you're going to exhaust your possibilities, you're going to actually feel like you've exhausted your possibilities. So there must be something else that I'm missing here. So we might as well do the thing that I haven't done yet, which is experiment with movement. So see, what happens if you do this, is you're going to get a follow through there, and then you're just going to get a gap. Which is essentially the same thing as if you just put that gap there yourself. But it does mean that your movements have gone in a different direction. Like, you've gone a different way. But these are still, these are still in order. And this is out of order. But the only way you've created something that's out of order is, there's a gap here. So you can't really take advantage of, this thing moving before this thing, because it's already done that. Like, it already did that back here. Like, this thing moved before this thing, so that thing went east, even though it would normally go north, it went east. But that hasn't changed my analysis of the path names, because it's still a matter of path names. So causing this thing to go east instead of north, which is the only thing I can do with movement, is only useful if for some reason there would be a conflict between the contradiction between having to force something to go north and something to go east and Beethro having to be in two places at once. That would fix that, but it doesn't change the fact that the path lengths are still the same. Like, this still has to be a path length of 5. This still has to be a path length of 4 or 5. And this has to be a path length of 4 or 5. So there's still something up. Is there any other way into this area? This never opens until the end. Beethro can't push anything onto the door. There's no pits. So it seems like the only way to actually get anything into this area is to have it go in through the door. There's no activation tiles or anything in there, so I can't, sneakily, put something out here and then have it come back to me in here. That's just not how this works. I mean, I guess I haven't done absolutely everything that I could do with an activation tile out here. I mean, sure, but, what could I do with a sun thing out here that I haven't tried yet? I can't put it onto the door. You can't push it onto the door. That's just not how these things work, right? Nope, you can't push it through a door or anything. I mean, it's important to make sure that you can't quantum tunnel these things through the wall. I mean, that would be very important to know, but no, that's not how these things work. And that closes, and that never reopens. And once you're in here, then you have to follow this path. You don't have to follow this path, actually. Like, I've been implying this whole time that once you were in here, you had to, do something like this. But you don't have to. You could go back and forth. You can do anything you want in here. So what would the advantages of that be, then? So what happens if I don't just go straight forward? I can delay as long as I want in here. Like, let's say I put something up here. I can delay as long as I want. Is there any significance to the force here? Like, I could go down here. I could get something. I could get 5-4 easily enough. That's not hard. So I could do that. Then I could go back up. I mean, sure, I don't know why I would want to do that, but I can. Could get the roach stuck on the force arrow. Then go back up. I don't know why I would want to do that, but I can. I can't go back and move them after I've put them on the force arrow. And then once it's on the force arrow, it has to be blocked by this. But it has to be blocked here or here. So again, you need a 4 or a 5. And then it blocks that, and then it goes through here, and everything's all great. But if it's here, if, like, instead of having a 5, I had a 6, I put that here, and the roach went there, then there's nothing that can be done. Can't be moved when I'm up here. And then if I go here, it seals this thing, and then it never hits this plate, and then I never can kill the, I can never kill these, the roaches. Well, okay, is that true? Like, I can't kill these sun things anymore. To kill the sun things, now they would be up here, so I would have to open this door somehow. Because I can't go in here to kill them. Like, let's say I did all that, put the roach somewhere, I don't even know where, but somewhere. Just get them all in here. Then I hit this plate. Then there's nothing I can do in here. Then I go back out. That didn't do anything. And it sealed this thing off. And there's no way to press this plate, so I can't, like, get at the roach or any of these guys anymore. There's nothing to press this anymore. This is open, but that doesn't help much. Okay, so I don't think I can break the puzzle, then, is I guess what I'm saying here. So what else can I do then? So all I get to do is move these things around. That's all I get to do with this chain. I can choose what order they go in. I can choose the gap size. I have plenty of room in here to do that. Like, I can choose the gap size. I can, instead of having, like, 5-4, I can delay things even further without needing any kind of shenanigans. I can just have it come in later. So I can, you know, translate one with respect to the other. But fundamentally speaking, one thing should be up here, and it should probably be number 2. So that would matter if putting something like 3, 2, or 1 actually helped, but it doesn't. Like, I want to put 5 and 4 here, but then 3 doesn't do anything. Or does it? Well, no, it's not going to do anything. 5, 4, 3 isn't going to help. Because what happens with 5, 4, 3... 5... Okay, well, even if I could do that, 5-4-3, 5-4-3, and to do that, I would have to somehow make this go east when that went north, and that's not gonna happen. There's no way to use movement order to cause that to happen either, because this is never gonna be here. Like, I could never have this be 3 and this be 4, because, it would get caught here instead of here. But even assuming I could do that, then this would be here instead of here, and that's just not any good for anything. So what happens if I try 5-4? Well then this is actually 5 and that's 6, because this is still 5 away. And now something up here has tried, that's back here is taking the long pass, so this just goes everywhere. Just further. There's nothing else I can put. Nothing else. And that's just a bad spot for the thing to be in. Now this path here is only 4 long, but that's plenty long for what it needs to do. Which is to do that. So, if by some chance the roach were here, then, like, I could, like, actually have enough time. But, you know, that's never going to happen. That's just a solid wall. And messing around up here doesn't do anything significant. Right, if this were somehow just one delay, then that would be okay. So that seems to imply that there is something up with the geometry there that I can change. Okay, this is a hard wall, but I'm sure that doesn't mean anything, right? Like, there's absolutely no significance to that at all. Well, I mean, it's not like I could get Beethro in there to inspect it, but I think that's probably just a bug, like a typo by the author, that this is a hard wall. Like, this is surely just meant to be a soft wall or something. Yeah, I'm not going to pay that any mind. It's not going to affect the behavior of these things as well. I mean, I clearly didn't notice the difference. Alright, well, if I'm reaching that far, I'm clearly just reaching way too far. Alright. So there's something here I'm missing. I'm going to have to come back to it later, but I understand what a good solution would look like. I know, like, good language for talking about this room. I'm just not there to actually solve it yet. Which is fine. I mean, that's understandable. He did say this is a hard room. So, we'll get back to this later. But still, it was worth a try. Well, what are you going to do then? Well, yeah, that's Broken Bridge, all right. All right, so what's going on here? Let's see. So you'll open as soon as that happens. What do? You do that, of course. So I need to kill everything in the room quickly, and I also need to... This one has to face east. I don't care what this one does. This can do anything. So this just has to kill things, and how many turns do I get? Let's phrase it in terms of this. So I could do this, that, and I can push things, but it still need to activate on certain turns. Not much time. Like, if I just go straight down, I get two turns of not going straight down. That is how tight this timer is. Okay, that's good to know. And then this one just always faces east. I can... But if I go straight... No, that's fine. So I'll go here, then I'll stab, then here... Yeah, then I can do that. That's fine. Okay, so going... I can kill all these in time. It's just this one has to just understand where these are going to be. So these are going to be... here, and so I'll stab that, then one will be here, right, because that'll move twice, and then I'll stab that, then this will have moved south, then this will have moved southeast again, so I'll kill that, and then it'll, like, probably be, like, over there or something. Okay, good enough. Right. Yeah, because I've only taken one extra move, I think. Alright, so what I'll want to record... Alright, so I want to record something like... you should wait here. Wait here. Okay. Now, I'll step here on the same turn. Wait here... So now he'll have stepped on the activation tile. This one will have moved over here. Because it's going to move towards this one. Yeah, it's going to move towards this one. I factored that in. Yeah. So this will have moved over here. You'll stab and kill this one. Then you'll have moved down here. Then next, this will have moved twice. So now I'll stab and kill that one. So next I just have to wait here. Sure. And then, right? Yeah, so I'll stab and kill this one. This will be on this row. Then I'll wait here. This will move here, and it'll cause this one to move down. Now I just have to move up here and stab and kill that one. I don't think I even have to record anymore. Alright, so now you go over there, wait for a signal. Alright, start a pistol, go. You go over there. Sure, good enough. That'll do. Alright. So, yeah, I didn't even have to... Like, obviously I didn't account for all that, but, you know, close enough. Close enough. Okay. So we got the, you know, the House of Mirrors. And, then we have to go in here and kill all of them. Okay, so it's just floating mirrors. I mean, what could be the problem with that? I mean, this is just a bunch of mirrors. What's up with this? Well, obviously we need, we're gonna need a certain amount of area. Alright, well, that's obviously, that's not a good spot. Do something more like that. I mean, as long as you just understand, like, what shapes are good and which ones aren't, then you're never gonna get trapped, so... Well, okay, the pits obviously make this a little bit more complicated, but that's okay. I mean, still nothing going wrong here yet. Let's see, so this is going to get a little bit more dicey here in a second. Yeah, how are we going to make it in here? That being the way. If I could move that there, then I would be set, so let's do that then. Now I think I can get back out. Yeah, now we should be fine. Nearly. Like, that was sort of the right idea, but not quite. Alright, yeah, now I think we're in a stable area. Okay, so that takes care of the northwest corner. We shouldn't make that square like that, but we can, you know, move ourselves down like this, make our good old Tetris piece arrangements. Tetris to the rescue once again. Yeah, is there anything that game can't solve? Well, I guess it can't solve loneliness. But, you know, that's, it's a little bit outside our grasp of even modern medicine, so, you know. And then this shouldn't be any harder than what I just did. I think that was, that, like, that first area was the hard part. Yeah, nothing out of the ordinary going on here. Then let's retreat back to the center. I said let's retreat. Yeah, let's go back this way. So far, so good. I mean, this is pretty standard mirror maze stuff here. And just, I mean, I'm not doing this in the most efficient way, I'm sure. There's probably a faster way to do this. That the high score demos would be all too eager to show me what it is, but. And kill, kill, kill everybody. Alright, well, that was easy enough. This was farther away from the start than some of the other stuff. But, you know, so be it. Okay, then. Ah, I see. Yes, so this is another secret room. Let's see, we've had, our standard 8 required rooms, and we've had 2 secrets here. Presumably this one is by Crimson Moon, the architect, and this is just an extra thing by Blorks that he suggested during testing. So this is our, well, okay, these two, the impossible ones that I got stuck on, were our last 2 required rooms. I guess I could fool around with this for a little while longer. It's because I just got done with that other one. So I have no reason to suspect anything else is amiss here, so I might as well just keep doing my Tetris pieces like I was earlier. Yeah, because I have the same amount of room. I only have 4 tiles, but that should be plenty. Alright, so Tetris pieces go. This is obviously going to be the hard part. Okay, so normally I'd like to go there to move that, but that's obviously not happening. And this is a little bit vexing too, the fact that this is here. So that's there. And that obviously limits my movement as well. So I can do something like that. But then I can't, like, go there to move that over or anything. So actually, that's a good question. How do I move this one? I'm gonna have to be standing here, so it's gonna have to go diagonally, which means that this is gonna have to be open. So that means I have to kind of shift my space over like this. So how do I move this one? Yeah, I move that one by having all 3 of these be open. So how do I move this one? This one has to be open. Okay. Well, now I'm starting to get somewhere, so yeah, I'm gonna have to crawl around, do stuff like this. Yeah, so far so good. And, yeah, crawl like this, and okay, so now I have this square. So now I just have to get out by somehow still having room for that. Like that, I guess. Sure, that looks good. Okay. So now that goes up there. Now we're still not really out of the woods yet. Yeah, how do we get back out? Okay. Alright, well, I'm gonna have to be a little bit more clever then. Yeah, I'm still gonna have to have room here. Yeah, I'm gonna have to... Like, I think instead of making Tetris pieces, I'm gonna have to make, like, snakes or lines or something. But that's going to be a bit more complicated than whatever it is I'm trying to do now. Like, I sort of have a right idea, but not quite. Like, I probably want to go back down here a bit. Actually, maybe we should just do this while we're here. This one looks easier. I mean, it's not going to be easy, mind you, because it's, well, that's obviously good. Alright, so that was easy enough. Get that one. Like, that one's just kind of a placeholder. I move that, then, yeah, I move that there. And then normally I'd step there to move that there, but I can't do that. Okay. So getting out might actually be a bit harder than I gave it credit for. Which is, you know, understandable, given this kind of... how's that? Yeah, that's better. Okay. Yeah, now we're getting somewhere. Okay, so now we're safely back in the center again. So we got the southeast corner. So the northeast corner... So if I can't come in, maybe I don't want to come in from the northeast. Maybe I want to come in from the southwest. Maybe that would make things easier for me. I have a feeling that might be easier than what I'm trying to do now. No, that's still not quite what I want. Yeah, I want to be able to go that way. That looks better. Yeah, that's better. Okay, so I've successfully crawled over this way. So to get this one out of the way, I have to clear, like, this area. So I need to kind of burrow myself in here. So that looks good. Now I've cleared that spot out. Now I just have to get out while still maintaining that spot clear. Which I am not good at doing, apparently. Like, if I had this spot open, then I could actually do it, I think. So maybe I need to figure out some way of... is there some way to get over to the southwest while having that square? Like, what if I do this, then? How's that? Alright, is that any better? Well, now I can't really get that last square space back now, can I? I mean, that was sort of... That was close, but it wasn't quite the right idea. So what if I push that over there, then push that over there, push that over there, push that over there, push that over there. Then push this over there, then we're trapped. But we can backswipe that into there, and then backswipe that into there. Except that's not any good. And normally I would step there and move that in, but that's not any good either. So I'll move that over there, just back in. Then push that over there, and push that over there. Then... Okay, how's this? Is that any better? Not especially. Yeah, that does not seem to have helped. Like, I need to have... Like, I'm sort of on the right track, but I need to have a better visualization capability of what a good situation for this would look like. This would be a lot easier to do with more space, of course, but I have enough. Like, I can get this, it's just that it's just not for what I'm trying to do. Okay, so I'm going to need to be a bit more clever than what I'm trying to do now, is what I'm saying. Like, if I can get this clear, then I can push this over there, and then I can push that, and from there I can probably get it, but it's still pretty iffy. Yeah, because I've gone astray from trying to like get to that corner. Yeah, and now there's nothing I can do. Okay, so this is harder than it looks, but I was expecting it. At least I got the southeast corner, which means I should probably take a demo of it before I completely restart. Just in case I need to remind myself of how I got in there. And now I'll restart completely. That's a very valuable technique. Because, like, I got part of the room done, so I want to save how I did that part. And, you know, I'll leave this part for later. Okay. Let's go fight Blorks later. He is a tough competitor. But, yeah, nothing to be done here. Alright, so we'll come back to these later. Maybe they're a bit out of our league. At least for the time being, because we aren't Sun Thing experts yet. So do I want to mess with this or this? I mean, I'm going to have to do these eventually. Let's mess around with this just for a little while longer, just to finish out the episode, and then I'll see from there. Okay, so what can I do differently this time? So this is the only... Okay, it's not the only way to start. I can start like... Well, I can't start like that. Start like that, then Beethro gets sealed in, and there's nothing to do. Once closed, these four stairs never open again. So the only thing that can really you just get out of the way. So the only thing that can hit these plates are monsters. Specifically, the only thing that can hit this plate is this construct, because the four stairs here never turn on. So something has to So this is the central conceit of the puzzle. How do you keep a construct from moving to this sword? You can use a sword one turn, but in order to make it go east, you would have to block this square with something that it can't push. Because if it tries to push it and go north, it's still going to want to go north if Beethro is over here. And if Beethro is blocking this square with his body, then the, you know, the construct is never going to go over. And it will push the sun thing under my sword. So that doesn't work. But what if Beethro makes his sword face southwest? So then, like, Beethro's standing here, the sun thing is here, then he moves his sword onto that square, like I noticed earlier. So I'll use the sun thing to help it get onto this square, then Beethro faces southwest and moves onto the hot tile. Then that'll force the construct to move here, because it can't move onto his sword. Even though it could move onto the sun thing, it can't move onto his sword. So then it'll go here, then I can get it on there, no problem. I don't even need to do anything special, I just wait here for the tar baby to go here. Then I go into the tunnel, and then everything's fine. I just have to kill this at some point. But that's fine, I can do all that. Let's do that, get all that done. Get all that. All right, sun thing, you have a very important job. You go here, get stunned here. Well, it's gonna have to. You go here, now you go here, now you face southwest, now you go here. And that blocks. The construct would like to have gone north to push that, but it can't because of swords there. So now we just have to kill sun thing. Right, and we have to go here because that's the only way to step on this sister gate as it closes with the tar baby killing itself there. So that allows us to leave the room when it's soft. Alright, that's good. So let's check that thing off then. Alright, so I guess next time we're going to have to come back to this thing again. Probably the hardest room on the level, I assume. I mean, the hardest room on the level is always the one I solve last, and I solve it last because it's the hardest. That makes sense, right?